The last time I saw this guy was at the Americana, and I've just spoken to Chris Jackson backstage. He tells me that sales for the Americana's going really well. Unfortunately, Bev isn't so good. His wife, Bev Jackson, she's not so good, she's in hospital. So we wish Bev a very, very speedy recovery, all right? Yeah, if you want to give Bev Jackson a great big round of applause, maybe she'll hear us. Come on. Keep that applause going for the wonderful, as Batman said, the rock and rollin' rim shots. Well, what can I say about tonight's, well, star guest? I compared him here at Hemsby, and a month later the phone went and it was that man on the phone. And that is what a great guy he is. He phoned me up to thank me for my job. Unreal. This is his third time at Hemsby, so third time lucky for him. Make him welcome if you will. It was Roy Orbison that introduced him to Sam Cornelius Phillips. And well, he in 1957 recorded with Billy Lee Riley, Jimmy Van Eaton, and the one and only James on the guitar for My Babe. Please, please put your hands together from Missouri, Texas, the one and only Narvel Felts.
Thank you.
Well, you can't be my loving baby. You ain't got the style. I'm gonna get me some real gonna love. I'll drive a cool cat wild. Gonna move it right on down. Gonna get me a gal that'll go out on the town. Well, gonna move on down the line. Gonna get me a gal that'll make some time. Can't be square, can't be slow, cause if we start strutting, we'll go, go, go. She'll be sweet, won't do me wrong. She'll be cool and twice as gone. Gonna move it right on down. Gonna get me a gal that'll go out on the town. Well, I'm gonna move on down the line. Gonna get me a gal that'll make some time. Can't be square, can't be slow, cause if we start strutting, we'll go, go, go.
Welcome to Hemsby. What an honor to be here with you again. And how about it for the rim shots? All right. Back to 1957 for my first record on Mercury. Here's Kissin' Me Baby.
Kiss me, baby, kiss me, pet. Give me thrill I can't forget. Take my arms, don't leave me blue. Kiss me, baby, please do. Kiss me, baby, kiss me, sweet. I'm a true love, I'm a no cheat. telling me you too, love me too, kissing me baby, please do. I'm so crazy baby, I'm insane. So crave a kiss on me, baby, kiss on me, baby. Give me thrill, I cannot forget. Take up my arms, don't leave me blue. Kiss on me, baby, please do. So crave a kiss of me, baby, kiss of me, pet. Give of me thrill, I can't forget. Take of my arms, don't leave of me blue. Kiss of me, baby, please do. Kiss of me, baby, please do. Kiss of me, baby, please do.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm not in good voice tonight. Got a little throat problem, and so say a little prayer for me that it lasts through the show, all right? I appreciate it. I'm gonna do a song now. This is actually the first song I sang in public. I did this one first, and when they wanted an encore, I did a new song I'd heard called Blue Suede Shoes, but this was the first one. Back at that high school talent contest in Burney, Missouri. Oh, baby, 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 come back, baby, I wanna play house with you. Well, you may go to college, you may go to school, you may have a pink Cadillac, but don't you be nobody's fool. Well, baby, come back, baby, come. Come back, baby, come. Come back, baby, I wanna play house with you. Well, listen, let me tell you, baby, what I'm talking about. Well, come on back to me, little girl, so that we can play some house. Well, baby, come back, baby, come. Come back, baby, come. Come back, baby, I wanna play house with you. To see you with another man. Well, baby, come back, baby, come. Come back, baby, come. Come back, baby, I wanna play house with you. Oh, let's play house now. So we could do what we did before. Well, baby, come back, baby, come. Come back, baby, come. Come back, baby, I wanna play house with you. Oh, baby, 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 baby. I'll be the baby, baby. I'll be the baby, baby. I'll be the baby, baby. I'll come back, baby. I wanna play house with you. Was the first charted hit by the Hillbilly Cat there. Here's a song that talks about those days back when rock and roll was new. Pink and black was the color fad for clothes and cars. And Most of us played the B&B Club in Gobbler, Missouri.
Well, pink and black clothes was the fad, and oh, what a real gone time we had when we had those rockabilly wings away back in the pink and black days. Well, I remember Elvis played at the B&B in Gobbler, Missouri, so did Jerry Lee and me, and we had those rockabilly wings away back in the pink and black day. Yeah, there was pink and black pintail Cadillacs, yellow sun records from Memphis were snapback. And at a drive-in theater in Dexter Mall with Roy Orbison and Eddie Bond, we did a show and we had those rockabilly wings in the pink and black day. Yeah, there was pink and black, a pintail Cadillac, yellow sun records from Memphis were snapback. And at the Casa Loma ballroom in Old St. Louis, with Gene Vincent and his band wearing caps that were blue, we had those rockabilly wings in the pink and black day. Yeah, they wore pink and black, the chicks on the daddy-o's listening to records were slap back liquor. Away back in the pink and black day. Away back in the pink and black day.
Would you mind if I have a drink of water after that? I sure do appreciate it. And would you mind if I have a sip of this concoction of lemon juice and honey here? And maybe I can get through the next one then. You know, in that era, I appreciate so much that you folks have rediscovered this music and kept it alive, because it actually had died until you did. Thank you so much. But you know, there was a lot more to it than just fast rockabilly songs. In order to work, we had to do a little bit of everything. Gerald Burke down at the B&B Club would have fired me if I did nothing but fast songs. So I had to do some ballads too. And here's one I first heard that year, about the time I was stumbling from the cotton fields to the stage. Little did I know that 20 years later, the folks that wrote this great song would be getting another award for it, that time for my hit record of it. When the twilight is gone and no songbirds are singing, when the twilight is gone, you come into my heart, and here in my heart you will stay. While I pray, my prayer is to linger with you
At the end of the day, in a dream that's divine, rapture in bloom, with the world far away, and your lips close to mine. Tonight, the same for as long as we live, that you'll always be there. At the end of my prayer and the answer you give, may they still be the same for as long as we have.
It's Liebedish. It's your Tama. Yaga Els Corde. Here's a song now. You know, the first package show I ever worked was back when I was a radio rockabilly, and it was on top of the concession stand at the Family Drive-In Theater in Dexter, Missouri. It was with Roy Orbison and with Eddie Bond. This was the summer of 1956, and I was 17 years old. And Roy was singing Ooby Dooby, and Eddie Bond was singing this one. Rockin' daddy, about it for the Rockin' Rim Shots? Yeah. I don't think I've ever worked with another girl upright bass player. Isn't she wonderful? Here's a song that goes back to 1959. One I recorded at High Studio in Memphis. And goes like this. Well, on Saturday night, I get the car from Pop. I got a tank of gas and a letdown top. I got a sweet little girl, a big eyes of blue. She got a cute little smile, her name's Cindy Lou. You got me in a stew, Cindy, Cindy, Cindy Lou. I'm so much in love with you. Well, all through the week, when I'm in school, I can't keep my mind on the golden rule. All I can do is dream of Saturday night, when I'm Cindy time. Oh, Cindy, Cindy, Cindy Lou. You got me in a stew. Cindy, Cindy, Cindy Lou. I'm so much in love with you. In a spin, I'm cutting class. I won't work at home, I won't mow the grass. My dad said, son, you better get some sense. Forget that girl and paint that bitch. In love with you, a Cindy Lou. Ah, thank you so much. You know, this is not in the script, but now that I've sung a few songs, I think maybe I can get through it. Willie wanted to hear this song.
The moon in the sky, softly creeping over the town from above. And I lie awake, hardly sleeping, so lonely for only your love. Even now, each night I remember days of summer when blossoms filled each bough. In the cold, gray day December, my darling, I miss you even now. When will I see you again? world will be empty till then. For you are the words to my song. Even now, each night I remember days of summer when blossoms filled each bough. In the cold gray days of December, my darling, I miss you even now. In the cold gray days of December, my darling, I miss you even now.
Comes from my Ode to Bub CD that I did back in 97 in memory of my son Bub, who used to play drums with me. How about it for the rim shots, unrehearsed on that one? Do you mind? Thank you. Ketos. Tucson talk. Donkey well. Donkashire. Merci beaucoup. Muchos gracias. Gracias. Thank you. Here's a song. This was one side of my first Mercury record back in 1957. Here's Foolish Thoughts, and I had a lot of foolish thoughts back in those days. I can't do a thing when I'm thinking of you. Lots of other guys with foolish thoughts of you. I wonder how it feels to have your popularity. I wonder what I'd have to do to make you think of me. But I realize there's lots of other guys with foolish thoughts of you.
Things I'm dreaming too are just foolish thoughts of you. you. Well, I wonder how it feels to have your popularity. I wonder what I'd have to do to make you think of me. But I realize there's lots of other guys with foolish thoughts of you.
Thank you so much. I'm going to go back to the script for the next one. Although this next one is a ballad, and it was originally scheduled, and I've done this in memory of my son, Bub, the last two times I've been here, this time I will also include it in memory of my buddy and a lot of yours, Paul Peek. Paul was one of the Blue Caps. He performed his last song on stage with me in Atlanta on the Saturday night before he died on Tuesday. He was a dear friend of mine. So, in memory of you, buddy.
Don't have plans and schemes, and I don't have hopes and dreams. I don't have anything since I don't have you. I don't have fun desires, and I don't have happy hours. I don't have anything since I don't have you. I don't have happiness, and I guess I never will ever again. When you walked out on me and walked old misery, and it's been here since then. Anything since I don't have you. Thank you.
Thank you. You're so wonderful. Thank you so much. Paul and Bub would both appreciate that. They both loved you. I guess you know that. Do you mind? Got a request for Blue Diamond. You talk about blue diamonds, big blue diamonds on her finger. That's all I know of it.
Good, it sounds like too many chords.
I'm sure Jackie Ward will appreciate you remembering that. I'm going to get Chris Jackson out in just a little while, and he's going to sing before the next teardrop falls. Then Willie Jeffrey and Ian Wallace are going to come out and do Wake Up Little Susie together. Here's a song now that I recorded at 706 Union in Memphis, Tennessee. Back in early 1957. Actually, Matt Lucas taught me this song when he found out I was going to get a chance to go down and audition in August of 1956. We were driving down a gravel road between Dudley and Poe, Missouri, in my green 42 Chevrolet, and he sung the song, tapping out the beat on the dashboard. And in early 1957, I had the chance to record this. Goes like this. Studio that day, Roy Orbison was in the control room with Jack Clement. Sam Phillips was back and forth from the front office through the studio to the control room. A man named Harold Jenkins, who would soon become Conway Twitty, had a chair drug out by my microphone. All of them listening to me as I recorded that song. And there was another guy there, a new piano player that was yet to have a hit record, but it wouldn't be long before there would be a whole lot of shaking going on. And you know, when I did the line in My Babe, "When she's hot, there ain't no cooling," Roy Orbison and Jack Clement, their heads popped around and looked at each other like it shocked them. And I sure hope Jerry Lee didn't hear that, and that's what led him astray. But it wouldn't be long before you shake my nerves and you rattle my brain. Too much of love drives a man insane. You broke my wind, what a thrill. Putting this crazy, great balls of fire. I let the love cause I thought it was funny. You came along like the groovy, huh? You changed my mind, I love this fire. I put in this gracious, great balls of fire. Kiss me, baby. I love a shoe. You're fine, so kind. Like to tell the world that you're mine, 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 mine. I got you my dose and then I put on my thumb. I've been never thought it you is fun. Come on, baby, drive me crazy. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. I've already strayed from the script once, that is. And you've been so kind to me to accept what I do. When I came into the rehearsal, not the rehearsal, the sound check this morning, there was a pretty young lady from Switzerland ran up to me and said, "Are you doing Reconsider Me?" I said, "I'm sorry, it's not in the script. I usually don't do that when I do rockabilly or rock and roll shows in Europe. But that actually was the biggest record of my career. It was actually the Billboard and Cashbox Country Single of the Year back in 1975. And so I think I'll stray from the script, non-rehearsed on this one, and do a verse and chorus of that Reconsider Me. Thank you all for being here. Thank you. From Switzerland. Hello, baby. Yes, it's really me. Guess you're surprised to see me. Here at your door, like a sparrow with a broken wing. Who's come back to beg you? Reconsider me. Consider me. I can't make it without you, girl. Can't you see? So please let me love you eternally. Consider me. Accepting my biggest country hit. I appreciate that so much. The country folks accept my rockabilly, and I appreciate you accepting my country hits, because all of it is a part of me. Someone asked me today in an interview, which do you like the best, country or rockabilly? And I had to be a diplomat and say, both of them are a part of me, and I just take the songs and narvelize them, and whatever happens. Yeah. thank you so much. Yeah. Well, I'll tell you what, we've strayed so far from the script. I tell you, I better do another rocker now, hadn't I? Song I wrote back in 1957, recorded it for Mercury, re-recorded it back in 97. Little thing called I'm Heading Home. Well, I'm leaving St. Louis and I'm heading south, along the Mississippi until I get to my house. Well, I'm going, yeah, going. He left the road, and then he got home.
he left the road. He got homesy and then he started home. They said, ahoy-yo, ahoy-yo, silver. Ahoy-yo, ahoy-yo, silver. Giddy-up-a-ding-dong, cousin.
See, we used to do wild and crazy things like that, but we don't do them anymore. Now it's your turn. Do y'all want to hear Lonely Teardrops, or do you want me to skip it? One person wants to hear it. Bernie wants to hear it. This actually was the second biggest record of my career, a top five country hit back in 1976, also a pop hit. Do you really want me to do this? You're sure? You're not just putting me on. Well, did the Shooby-Doo-Wahs make it in from Muscle Shoals? We'll do it at F, the original key, and I'll hope I get through it. Okay, how about it for the Shooby-Doo-Wahs? Thank you so much. Am I going overtime, Willie? I'm sorry. Before I do this next song, I would like to remind you that Howard's Record Rack will be open in the lobby. He has 5 different CDs of mine. He has 2 different cassettes, a variety of my music from the original recordings of the 50s, the hits of the 70s, and also there's 4 different pictures out there. You can have your choice of Narvel now or then. And I'm looking forward to seeing you out there. And as always, I will be there till the last of you that wants to meet me comes through the autograph line. So I'll look forward to immediately after my show. I'm not going to wait and towel off or anything like that. I'm going right out there. So I'll meet you out there. Right now, I thought I'd tell you that just in case there's not an encore and I don't get to do another song. Because I never take those things for granted. Right now, here's a song that J.W. Grubbs and I wrote sitting on the fender of my green 42 Chevy in the park in Dexter, Missouri. We recorded it on January 23rd, 1957 at Sun Records in Memphis. And thank you for accepting Did You Tell Me? Some of you call it You Don't Care.
Tell me that you love me. Did you tell me that you care? Did you tell me that you wanted me to be there? Well, come on back to me, my baby. Come on back home to me. Come on back and to make me happy. Hey, what a happy daddy. Well, did you tell me that you love me? Or did you tell me that you care? Or did you tell me that you wanted, really wanted me to be there? You left me all alone, my darling. Well, you left me without a care. But now I want you more than ever, more than I should ever dare. So come on back to me, my baby. Well, come on back home to me. Come on back and you make me happy. What a happy daddy. Well, did you tell me that you love me? Or did you tell me that you care? Or did you tell me
rim shots. Narvel Felts. Do you want some more? If you want some more, you've got to say three words as loud as you can. We want more. We want more.
You're so wonderful. I appreciate that. My goodness, thank you. I didn't think this could happen again. You've been so wonderful to me twice here at Hemsby, now three times. Three of the real highlights of my life and my entire career. And I appreciate that so much. Thank you. I'll tell you what I'd like to do right now. Right now, there's a guy on the show that he's been my buddy since I was a radio rockabilly back in 1956. He did a wonderful, great show here last night. He used to play in my band at the end of one of my recording sessions with just me and him and J.W. Grubbs, and with him singing, he cut a smash hit. And then I played guitar for him for a while. And last night he was kind enough to call me out on stage to play guitar on his hit record, I'm Moving On. And there's a song I recorded. I didn't do a very good job on it. But you folks in Europe seem to like it. My buddy Charlie Feathers wrote this song. And Matt played drums on my record of Tongue Tied Jill. Would you make Matt Lucas welcome? Matt Lucas. Charlie Feathers told me the right words to this song. The last time I talked to him on the phone, I wrote them down and then I lost them. So I'll just have to sing them the way I know it again. We'll be right back.
said Narvel the Marvel, Matt Lucas, and the Rimshots. I told you before, if you want some more, do you want some more? Narvel said he had a sore throat. No way. 20 press-ups and a sore throat. Do you want some more? Well, I don't know. I think he's just about bushed. Maybe we could squeeze one more. I think they want some more Narvel. It was back in 1999, Eddie Bond presented Narvel Felts with a Lifetime Musical Achievement Award. I think it's about time he had another one. Mr. Narvel Felts.
Thank you. Well, after my guitar falling on the floor, I bet it's in terrible tune. Oh. I can't play that. So. Okay, John's gonna tune me. If I'd have known there's gonna be another, I would have tried harder to not let that guitar fall off of my back while I was doing those push-ups. May have broke a key off of it. But it's been getting treatment like that since 1978, so. I don't know what we're gonna do, but we'll do something. But thank you for being so wonderful and calling me back out here. I wasn't expecting that, and I didn't have anything prepared. John is magic, isn't he? I was all right for a while. I could smile for a while. But I saw you last night. You held my hand so tight as you stopped to say hello. Though you wished me well, you couldn't tell that I'd been crying over you, cry.
said so long, left me standing all alone, alone and crying, 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 crying. It's hard to understand how the touch of your hand could start me crying. I thought that I was over you, but it's true, so true. I love you even more than I did before, but darling, what can I do? You have to love me, so I'll hurt.
Ladies and gentlemen, the legendary Narvel Felts.
God bless you. I love you. Thank you.